Instant messaging app WhatsApp is changing its terms of service to force users to share personal data, including phone numbers and locations, with its parent company, Facebook. Now, to begin with, WhatsApp claims to be end-to-end encrypted, which means your messages are safe and can only be accessed or read by the communicating users. But the new policy changes suggest an increasing reliance on other Facebook products. The important question here is, should we be worried? Well, yes. Social media platforms were buzzing as users started getting in-app notifications on WhatsApp between late Tuesday evening and Wednesday morning, informing them about the new policy changes. Since then, a lot of users are confused and are trying to figure out what exactly do these changes mean for them. Well, let's break it down for you. It is interesting to note that WhatsApp has at least 400 million users in India alone. This also means that there is an enormous amount of data that the app is collecting and sharing and is probably at risk. When we talk about WhatsApp sharing data with its parent company, Facebook, what sort of data is at risk? Well, almost everything. WhatsApp collects a vast amount of user information and data as compared to other popular messaging apps, including Signal and Telegram. The details available on the App Store shows that Facebook Messenger leads when it comes to user data collection, followed by WhatsApp. The list of data collected includes user purchase history, financial information, location details, contacts, phone number, email addresses, and user data. Beyond this, the platform will collect data from the new payment feature, including processing method, transactions, and shipment data. It will also collect and share location, device model, operating system, battery level, and browser details. WhatsApp's new privacy policy says that even if you don't use location-related features, it will collect IP addresses and other information like your phone number area codes to know your location. How you use WhatsApp, your service settings, how you interact with other users, how much time you spend on the app, and even the duration in which you use WhatsApp, your profile picture, your status, and much more is at risk. This is some sensitive information for every person who uses the application. To understand this better, when you use Google Drive or iCloud to back up your chats, these services are getting access to your messages. Similarly, with the new policy changes, WhatsApp is elaborating further on what it means by data sharing when users rely on these third-party integrations. Interestingly, users have been left with little option this time and will have to accept these terms and changes if they want to continue using their WhatsApp accounts. You will have time to accept WhatsApp new terms and conditions. A pop-up will appear on your smartphone to inform you about these changes. If you do not accept these changes, then your account will be deleted. In July 2020, WhatsApp had given its users an opt-out choice on sharing usage data. The company had said if you're an existing user, you can choose not to have your WhatsApp account information shared with Facebook to improve Facebook ads and product experiences. However, that clause has now been removed from the updated policy, making it mandatory for users to give consent to WhatsApp to collect and share data. The older version of the privacy policy mentioned that the respect for user privacy is coded into the company's DNA. However, these lines are no longer a part of the new privacy policy. What is also concerning is that if you disagree with these new policy changes and decide to delete your account, it does not mean that the data from your app will also be deleted. According to WhatsApp, when you delete your account, it does not affect your information related to groups you created or the information other users have related to you. The policy also warns that when you message with a business on WhatsApp, you should keep in mind that the content you share may be visible to several other people in that business. Then how is your data safe, and how can you be sure about how your data is being used and if it is being shared with third-party service providers? The recent policy changes have raised some serious privacy concerns and also contradict what the company initially promised back in 2014 during the acquisition by Facebook, when it assured that its goal is to know as little as possible. The updated policy hints towards a larger Facebook ecosystem that Facebook CEO had suggested, where WhatsApp, Instagram, and Messenger app could be used interchangeably. Several digital experts have claimed that the updated WhatsApp terms will help Facebook and connected third-party apps to exploit user data for commercial gains, including personal data, breaching users' privacy. What we have understood is that WhatsApp's new privacy policy lacks clarity and fails to shed light on how data from Facebook, WhatsApp, and Instagram is being combined and who is it being made available to.